Hi, my name is Chip Ritter, and I'm going to show you one of my favorite patterns. My friends are sick of it, but you might never have seen it before. So I'm going to show you. Goes like this. Right, left, right, right, left, right, right, left. It's that simple. Seriously. All kinds of cool stuff. So many uses. Like I said, my friends are sick of it because I'm always posting about it. But check out what you can do with it. Just one. All right. The cool thing about this pattern is if you cycle it twice and you're thinking about 16ths, the left hand ends up on the snare on the backbeat. You can accent the left hand and you create a backbeat so you can play all kinds of grooves. So let's try to practice it over and over and over and over and over and over and over. Right, left, right, right, left, right, right, left. Right, left, right, right, left, right, right, left. Over and over. That a lot forever until you're good at it and you can do it in your sleep. Then we're going to try to take the right hand over to the hi-hat and we're going to try the same thing, but think about 16th notes. Right, left, right, right, left, right, right, left. One E and a, two E and a. You see how the two ended up on the snare? One E and a, two E and a. If I pop that two or get good at accenting that one note, then I can have a backbeat with it. And then I can add the bass drum if I want. If you think in terms of a full bar of 16th notes, then you can add different patterns, like do a beat like this. To do that beat with this sticking, all you have to do is do it twice. Beat. And pattern. Get it? And then the cool thing is you can also do accents within it. Like if I accent the first of the two rights, it gives a context to it, a little bit of texture. I could also accent the second right, like, that's my favorite. Okay, so the first of the rights, and then the second of the second rights. Watch this. It's kind of tricky, but. It may take some of you guys a while to get that. It took me a while to get it. But again, the placement is cool because if you're doing that sticking and you got that accent pattern and you're doing those accents, you could put that on the tom like this. And if I do it again, it turns into this funky kind of. I think is really fun. And let's not forget how fun it is to shuffle stuff once you got this. Practice this. Guys, dug it. Please leave a comment. Let me know what you think. If you like it or you want to see something else or more specific things from me on videos like this, let me know. And I guess that's it. Keep time, have fun, and be yourself.